Hello and welcome to another video, a part of the Beekeeping Beginner Course playlist. Thanks for all the positive messages that you've given me across this past week and a half. I want to say thank you for the large amount of support that I've had, and all the improvements that will be taken into consideration. Now, due to the fact that my video on what hive you should choose did so well, I've done doing a new series which will show you a more detailed explanation on the hive. Now today we're going to be looking at the WBC.
En apparence, les choses sont très faciles pour vous. Vous êtes jeune, vous êtes jolie. Vous êtes jeune, vous êtes jolie.
WBC was started by Mr. W.B. Carr, and it was made in 1890. So the WBC is a double-walled hive, and it's also, I'm pretty sure, the most popular double-walled hive which is used here in the UK. Now if you ask a brand new beekeeper or somebody who hasn't done beekeeping what a beehive looks like and expect them to have a look at the WBC, they'll straight away think of the WBC because it's such an iconic hive. Now as you will know, the hive is such a nice looking factory, but that comes with a price. So for a complete hive from Paynes, you are going to be looking at around 462 Great British Pounds. So that's a lot more than the usual hive that you are looking at. So we're going to be looking at the pros and cons of this hive now. Now behind us we have the WBC hive, and the first thing that you will notice is the roof. Now the roof goes like that, which, I mean, it looks great. However, if you're looking to increase the amount of hives that you have from around 5 hives up, I'd say that this can be a bit of a problem, because usually when I take the supers off, I'll put the flat roof down on the national, and then I'll put the supers on top. This allows them to be raised from the ground, which is a lot nicer because you're not getting all the dirt that's on the ground up into the super. The next thing is the entrance. Now the entrance has like a sliding piece of wood which you can pull in and out to reduce the size of the entrance. Now it's a great idea. However, when walking around the hive, you can get your legs stuck on it and you can kind of walk into it, and that slight injury and a bit of pain will be caused there. Now we have a pro and a con put into one on this next point. We have the floor. Now the floor actually comes with the hive as normal, but the floor is basically a stand built in, so you have the floor and then legs pointing down. It's great because you're getting a floor built in with your hive and a stand. Well, you should with that price. But it's a bit of pain for transport. When putting it on a trailer, usually you can just strap it up and you won't have any legs, you'll just slide the floor straight on. Well, here you can't really, because you're gonna have the legs there, which could make it a little bit dodgy when traveling on a trailer with a lot of these. Can be a bit of a pain. Now let's move on to the pros while we can. First of all, it's double walled. I know that a lot of users of the WBC say that with the national and the WBC, they haven't seen much of a difference across the winter for insulation wise, but I do think that the double walls here could possibly help in the winter, especially if you could get a thin insulation block to fit in there. I think that it could give the bees a bit of an advantage going into the winter. The WBC brood box is a 10 frame box, and it's based on a national, but the inside layer is the walls are slightly thinner, which I suppose you don't need the thick walls like the national hive because you have two layers, which is again a form of insulation. Now the national frames, so you could have a national hive and a few WBCs found there, and it shouldn't make too much of a difference because they're the same frames. Now as this hive isn't in use, we can take a little look inside and I'll show you what it's about. But from users, I've got on my notes here that maintenance is needed, regular maintenance, because damp can get inside here and it can be a bit of a pain. So I'm going to run through some of the dimensions of the hive. So when you are looking to get the WBC, you'll know the dimensions. So it's pretty much the same as the national hive. You can fit 11 frames in there. It's a 14 by 8.5, which is exactly the same as the national, obviously. And then on the frames, you have the long lugs, just like the national hive. So let's go and take a look inside. Now, as you can see, we're going to take this gaped roof off. The first thing that I've noticed, it's pretty heavy, which is probably, it could be a good thing, I suppose, that you don't have to put a brick on top or strap it together. Ugh. So now we've got, look at it, it's you've got the slats there, it does really look quite attractive. And if you have two of these in your back garden, I think everybody, all your visitors will love it, and it'll be great for a couple of photos. So as you can see now inside, we have our outer shell here, the white one, and then inside we have our national box. Now as you can see, around the edge here, walls are a lot thinner than what you would have on a national hive. Let's move on to the next point, which I talked about, which is down below here. So we still got our sliding part here. So this is quite nice, I suppose, a little touch. You can slide it in and out, which will reduce the entrance size, which saves you from putting in different entrances and taking entrances out in the summer. So there you go, you can just slide it out. And if you have it out just slightly, you can catch your leg when walking around the hive. So I'm going to move you onto the floor. Very nice. We have our nice landing board here for the bees to land on. And then we have the legs, which are built in to the floor, which is again a nice touch, but it can be a bit of a pain if transporting hives. Do buy secondhand hives. Somebody said that to make sure they are the right size and compare it with the rest of your hives that are in your stock. Now if you're starting beekeeping, you want to kind of get into a more serious game with bee farming maybe, then I would recommend you scrap this idea altogether and go for maybe a Langstroth or national, like what we have here at our apiaries. Yeah, so then again, I think that this hive is great, and when you paint it in a nice cream or white colour, for your back garden, if you're looking at a maximum of 5 hives, this hive would be great for you, especially if you have quite a bit of money there to spend on the hive. But just remember that you can get cheaper hives that look just as good. We've got more videos coming on, so if you do like the quality of these videos, then please do subscribe. When subscribing, hit the little bell, and that will also tell you when I've uploaded a brand new video. So just looking at the hive, it does look great, and there are other hives out there that look just as good, but you do need to take into consideration the other hives that are out there and might possibly give you a bit more of an advantage. Now, I do suggest that you kind of go with the same hive that you have in your local association if you're starting out. In my local association, we have national hives. Now, I have seen the rise in the WBC hives in the past few years, but honestly, a lot of beginners go for that choice and it's not the right choice for them. And if you're looking at increasing the amount of stocks that you have, then you're probably going to want to go for something a little bit more sensible, which you can use instead of, if you're going commercial, then you're going to want to inspect the hives. You're going to be doing it quite often, a lot of apiaries, so you don't want to have 10 of these hives and 10 nationals and 10 WBCs. That would be a bit of a mess. If you go to your association, see what works best with you. If they have a couple of WBCs that they want to inspect, get in there, see whether the WBC is right for you. See whether you're going to be able to work with the sloped roof and the fact that you're having two shells there. Because obviously, if you buy one of these for 460 odd quid, you're not going to want to mess up there. That's quite an expensive mistake that you're going to regret for the rest of your beekeeping life. But then again, if you're only going to get at least, if you're only going to have two hives, then of course this hive could be great for you if you're looking for something stylish for your back garden. For me, I would just go plain simple and just go for what the crowd has. I know that a lot of people have hives that are slightly different and aren't as popular. I know that people like quirky things, and to be honest, I prefer to just go plain simple, and I want it to be as easy as possible, especially when you're spending days and weeks inspecting hives. So as you can see here, it's great because you have these kind of outer shell, which it looks great because of the slats. It kind of goes down, and I'll just take the top off here. And then obviously, so you can see there, we have our boxes inside there, which we'll have here. This is a super. Here. Yeah, so also, as you can see here, you have your outer shell and then your inner shell, which here is super. And then obviously, you just have your normal hive, there's nothing different. I think we conclude this video. I hope you check out more of the videos as part of this brand new series that's going on. Now, there's a lot more work involved if you are owning one of these hives, and if you are a WBC owner who's actively using these hives, either on Facebook or on YouTube, and tell us what your experience with the WBC and how many hives you have, and whether the WBC has put obstacles in the way for you. Now, please subscribe and give us a like. And I'll be bringing more videos on the hives, such as the flow hive, which is being used in our apiary at the minute, and the Langstroth, and of course the national hive. And also, I'd like to check out a few more hives which aren't as popular, which would be great and would help the channel altogether. So now we're going to be putting the roof back on and we'll conclude this episode. Because I hang on.